Hey, what's up guys? My name is the Cherno and welcome back to my C++ series. Today we're going to be continuing on our adventure through object-oriented programming and talking about inheritance in C++. So, object-oriented programming is a huge paradigm, and inheritance between classes is one of the fundamental aspects of it and one of the most powerful features that we can actually leverage. Inheritance allows us to have a hierarchy of classes which relate to each other. Or in other words, it allows us to have a base class which contains common functionality, and then it allows us to kind of branch off from that class and create subclasses from that initial parent class. The primary reason why this is so useful is because it helps us avoid code duplication. Code duplication refers to where we have to have the exact same code multiple times, doing maybe slightly different things at other times, just exactly the same thing. But instead of us repeating ourselves over and over again, we can put all of our common functionality between classes into a parent class and then simply make subclasses from that base class, which either change the functionality in subtle ways or introduce entirely new functionality. But the idea is inheritance gives us a way to put all of that common code between a number of classes into a base class so that we don't have to keep repeating ourselves, kind of like a template. So let's take a look at how we can actually define that in our source code. Suppose that I had an entity class, and this was going to govern pretty much every actual entity that I had in my game. We have a lot of very specific entities in our game. However, to some aspect, they will share functionality. For example, perhaps every entity has a position inside our game. This might be expressed through two floats, for example. So we'll have float X and float Y. Next, we might want to give every entity the ability to move, perhaps via a move method. So we'll take in an XA and a YA being the amount that we want to move by. Okay, great. So we've got a base entity class. We basically said that every single entity we create in our game will have these traits. Let's go ahead and create a new type of entity. For example, a player. We'll write our player class, for now with no concept of inheritance. So basically, if we were doing this from scratch and we wanted this player to also have a position, because it is an entity and it makes sense for it to have a position inside our game, we would also want to get it to be able to move, so we would need the move function carried across. We would basically end up writing something that looks fairly similar to this. Maybe this player class has extra data that we wanted to store, for example, a name or something like that. We would add this, so you can see that these are actually different classes. However, there's quite a lot of code that's just been copied and pasted, and that's this entire section. So what we can do here is use the power of inheritance. We could extend this entity class to create a new type called player, and then also have it store new data, such as a name, as well as provide extra functionality, such as a function that doesn't exist in the base class. And there we go. So now let's get player to be a subclass of entity. The way that we do that is we write a colon after the type declaration here, class player, and then we write public entity. Okay, so now with this line of code that we've written here, a few things have actually happened. The player class now not only has the type player, it also has the type entity, meaning that it actually is both of those types. Types in C++ are quite a complicated topic because on one hand, they don't really exist. However, on the other hand, they kind of do, especially if you have certain runtime flags activated. We're not really gonna get in depth about how this whole thing works just yet, but definitely something for the future. The other thing that's occurred is that player now has everything that entity has. So all of these class members that we have, such as X and Y here, two floats, they are now also included in here. So right now we've actually got four floats total in the player class. We've got these two that we have here that are just the copied and pasted ones, as well as the original two. So let's definitely get rid of all of that duplicated code here, so that we only have everything that's new, such as the name, which is a const char pointer, and the print name function, which is kind of our additional functionality example. Okay, cool. So the player class is looking really clean now. However, it is actually an entity, which means that just looking at this class doesn't actually tell us the whole story. We have to go up and find the entity class and see what it has, because as far as the player is concerned, anything that is not private inside the entity class is actually accessible by player. Let's go ahead and test this out. Suppose that I create a player class instance here. I can now not only call the print name function, which you can see exists in player, but I can also call move and access X and Y. Just like this, just as if it was an entity. I could provide it with certain parameters for where I want it to move. I can access X and Y as if it was an entity, because it's inherited all of that entity functionality. Another concept that we can use this with is something called polymorphism, which we'll actually dive into in a future video. But basically, polymorphism is the idea of having multiple types for a single type. So remember how I mentioned that player is not only the type player, but also is an entity? it means that we can actually use a player wherever we wanted to use an entity. And that makes sense because the player has everything the entity has, plus a little bit more. And it doesn't even have to have more. That's something that we've added. It could be exactly the same, but player is always going to be a superset of entity, meaning that player is always going to have everything that entity has, and possibly more. Meaning that if I wanted to create a standalone function which printed an entity object, for example, perhaps by accessing the x and y variables and just printing them to the console, I could actually pass in a player object into that same function, even though it accepts an entity as a parameter. And the reason that's possible is because a player type, a player class, is guaranteed to have those x and y variables, because it has to. It's a subclass of entity, meaning it's got all of that entity stuff in it. There are so many things that we can do here, such as all of those polymorphic features. We can also change the behavior of our superclass or our base class, for example, by overriding a method and giving it new code to run instead. But the takeaway from here today is that inheritance is something that is used all the time. It's just a way for us to extend an existing class and provide new functionality to a base class. It's one of the most important things in object-oriented programming. And remember, when you create a subclass, it will contain everything that your superclass contains. Another great way to prove this is that, remember, we have two floats here, x and y, inside entity. Let's go ahead and print the size of an entity object to our console. So I'll just do size of entity. If I hit F5 here to run my code, you can see that my size is 8, which is what you would expect because we have two floats in the entity class here, x and y. Now let's go ahead and print the size of player. Now, if player did not extend entity, if player was just a class of its own, it would only have this const char pointer, which should be 4 bytes of memory on a 32-bit application. However, since we are extending entity, it means that it inherits all of the variables that are inside that entity class. So it should actually be 4 plus 4 plus 4, which is 12. Let's go ahead and hit F5 and see if that's right. As you can see, it is. So you can see that we've literally inherited everything entity has. It's almost as if we've copied and pasted everything that entity has into the player class, because the player class is now an entity and that additional functionality, that name that we've added. Keep in mind that the size of these classes in memory can actually vary. If we started overriding functions in player, then we'd actually have to maintain something called a vtable, which is extra memory that we'd have to occupy. Not gonna get into that right now, but that is the gist of how inheritance works in C++. Over the course of this series, we'll be breaking down all the individual concepts to do with object-oriented programming, polymorphism, inheritance, all of that stuff individually and in depth. So definitely stick around for that, because we're not even scraping the surface. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye. Phew. Oh man, this hair today. It's just perfect.